does not throw a really sharp ball. It's more of a catchable ball, kind of a Joe Montana style, and Mylay was able to get a punch on it.
Cooper Rush now 16 of 25 on the day. Second down and 10. Spaulding. Nowhere really to go. Gets a yard. Mylay and Chad Whitener combined for the tackle.
Good penetration by the Pokes defense there. And Spaulding, even before he got the handoff, was trying to make a cut to the outside. And if you're trying to make a cut before you get the handoff because of penetration, that is not a good omen for the future of that run play. Big third down here. Remember, it was a third down that Cooper Rush was able to throw that touchdown pass in the red zone.
Third and 9. Jare Hayes is in on third down for CMU. Over the middle, the pass is incomplete. Anthony Rice can't hang on to it. He was going to be short of the first down marker anyway. Trey Flowers was right there.
Trey Flowers, young man out of San Antonio. Good looking safety, very athletic guy. Great triple jumper in high school. Right on top of the play by Rice, but the catch should have been made.
Central Michigan now 2 for 8 on third downs on the day. Cooper Mojienko on to punt. Jalen McCleskey is back at the 15. A low kick taken at the 20 by McCleskey. McCleskey with that speed able to turn the corner and gets run out of bounds around the 35. They're going to mark him out at the 38. It's a 38-yard punt, a 17-yard return. Mason Rudolph, 15 of 24, 153 yards in that first half, a couple of touchdowns. Did not turn the ball over. McCleskey, 7 catches, 50 yards, had the 1 touchdown. James Washington, 4 catches for 67 yards. He also drew that
big play nature, really.
Yeah, he also drew that pass interference. And they'll start with good field position here on their first drive of the second half. At the 38-yard line, Chris Carson in the backfield. Handoff is to Carson. Carson got hit in the backfield, tried to break free. DeAndre Dill was the first to make contact. Big number 95, the true freshman out of Chester, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, a 310-pound guy. They need those over 300-pound guys on that front to take on a Big 12 offensive line. And they are not able to break the first tackle at all, any of these running backs for Oklahoma State. You got to give the chips a...
On second down, the pass is floated to Juwan Seals, completed for 5 yards. Josh Cox with tackle number 7 on the afternoon.
Sure tackling from everybody. Real lot of credit you got to give this defense for really finding their way after getting hit with some tempo late in the first quarter.
Now third and 5. Rudolph, high pass to McCleskey, is dropped. McCleskey was hit right away by Winslow Chapman. So good defense once again by the Chippewas.
You're going to see McCleskey, he plays that inside position, just curls around very nicely. The ball's a little high, but there's no reason it shouldn't have been caught.
Zach Seiner to punt. Emmett Thomas back at his own 10 to receive. Low punt takes a good Oklahoma State bounce, and this will be down at the 11-yard line. A 47-yard punt. Central Michigan ball from their 11 when we come back down by 7.
At Lexus, What we learn on the track doesn't stay on the track. It just finds more street legal form. Experience the power and precision of the Lexus F-Sport Performance Line. This is the pursuit of perfection.
We got married in June.
On Tuna Day. There's a Subway 350 sub of the day to help you remember life's important days. Every day, a different 6-inch sub for just $3.50 every day of the week at Subway.
Her name is Terry.
She was born on Sweet Onion
Chicken Teriyaki Day.
Starbucks Double Shot Coffee and Protein. With the lift of real brewed Starbucks coffee, plus the power of 20 grams of protein, it's all you need to do even more. Starbucks Double Shot, real life energy.
Americans don't celebrate the Good Enough Canyon. We didn't aim to be second to the moon. Verizon doesn't settle for good enough either. So now we're introducing Verizon LTE Advanced. With 50% faster peak speeds in more than 450 cities coast to coast. So don't settle for an unlimited plan with limits. Switch now and get our best deal. 20 gigs of limitless data with 4 lines for only $160. Welcome to the Next Gen Network.
My fellow Americans, they say we're a nation divided.
That's not true. We agree on a lot.
Like Paul Rudd. Everybody loves Paul Rudd.
I didn't know this was going to happen.
You know what else everyone loves?
Emojis.
No beer!
That's why we're forming the Bud Light Party. Just wait till you see our caucus.
We got the biggest caucus in the country.
Woo-wee!
I'm really inspired right now.
America has seen the light.
And there's a bud in front of it.
The head coach for Central Michigan, John Bonamigo, in his second year. Year number two has been so different than year number one. Last year, after being named the head coach, shortly after was diagnosed with tonsil cancer. And this guy, what he went through is unbelievable. Was coaching during camp while he was going through chemotherapy and radiation. This is a look, the final day when he finished all of his treatments, got to ring the bell in Ann Arbor. He lost 70 pounds during the treatments. He overcame cancer, and he led his team to a bowl game last year. Speaking to him on the phone this week, it was remarkable. On first down, Cooper Rush just throws one up incomplete to Jesse Kroll. But, Petros, you and I have been on a lot of calls. We've met with a lot of coaches in our time. That was one of the most impressive phone calls I've ever been on.
Yeah, the guy gets his dream job, and then he's diagnosed with tonsil cancer months later, now declared cancer-free in November of 2015. Him and his wife, Paulette, had been through so much with this program. But when somebody goes through that and you're in a football team in a meeting room watching the head coach sacrifice for you in that way, it brings a team closer together. And these guys have been through a lot, and they play like it. They trust each other.
It's second down and 10 here for Central Michigan. Rush has to get rid of it. He does. He finds Chapman. And Chapman able to slide through to get a couple before Ashton Lampkin brings him down.
Now remember, these backed up three and outs, that's what caused the trouble for Central Michigan defensively in the first half. And here's another big third down and long. Backed up. They can't afford another one, because remember, once this Central Michigan defense gets a little tired, the tempo of Oklahoma State really hurts them, and that's how these games get away from you.
Third and 7. Rush able to complete the pass and slipping a tackle. Is Jonathan Ward out of the backfield, picks up 17, a huge third down conversion. The true freshman out of Illinois.
You're going to see this Texas route come right across, and he gets it. He makes the catch and is able to run out of the arm tackle. Finds himself, I think, a little bit surprised in the open field, and finds the first down. Huge for the Chippewas' field position, confidence, and the rest of their defense on the sideline.
So now first and 10 from the 31. And the handoff is to Ward. Ward, the freshman who had 9 carries for 79 yards last week, including a 45-yard touchdown run, picks up 5 here on first down.
Yeah, he's from an exotic place for a Central Michigan guy, Illinois.
83 players from the state of Michigan who are on the Central Michigan roster.
And this guy's a very good athlete, just a freshman, but you can see a little bit electrifying when he gets the ball. Second in the state in the long jump in Illinois his senior year in high school.
Second and 5. Bocci is in. And this time, not able to turn the corner as Ward. Ramon Richards tracks him down and brings him down at the line of scrimmage. No gain at the play.
You're going to see Jonathan Ward here. He should put his foot in the ground and take that ball up. He had the blockers. He was going to get hit, but he had a 4-yard gain. But a lot of freshmen want to take it to the sideline because that's what they did in high school. There's nothing out there for you. Not against a Big 12 team with a guy like Ramon Richards ready to take you down.
Ramon Richards with 6 tackles on the day. Central Michigan 2-for-6 on third downs. Tyler Conklin in motion, a tight end. Rush finds Conklin wide open. Conklin down the sideline. He's got the first down and much more. Up to the 42, picks up 18, tripped up by Trey Flowers.
And he found himself all alone, kind of on the backside of the route. Rush finds him coming across on a drive route. I like how Conklin really made sure he secured the ball first and got the first down, and then started lumbering down the field.
Tyler Conklin is a transfer from a small division school, was a basketball player, now playing football. And this kid, he's got good hands, good size, already a touchdown on the day. Play action, pressure coming, and Rush is going down. DeQuinton Osborne with the sack.
Rush got a little beat up on that one. He's trying to find his composure. This is what happens when you have a freshman back in the game. You're going to see Ward get a little bit confused in the pass protection, come on the wrong side of the quarterback and try to pick up Quinton, but just no chance there. Almost a jailbreak. The Mike linebacker came as well, and the Chips didn't have a chance.
A loss of 9. And so now the true freshman Ward, he's on the sideline. Second down and 19. Back to their own 49-yard line as Devin Spaulding is back in. Rush steps into his throw, completes the pass to Zach Crouch, who got hit right away by Ramon Richards. A 5-yard completion, but Richards went low against the 6'5 Crouch, and that's just a good tackle by a corner against a tight end.
Yeah, a couple of good tackles on this drive for Ramon Richards, and these third longs are especially difficult for this Chippewa offense. They are built in a way to convert third and shorts. They have a very experienced quarterback who can make things happen, but this is not a deep threat team, essentially, against an Oklahoma State secondary.
Third and 14. Rush throws, and that one is almost picked off. Juggled. There is a flag on the field. Eric Cooper, the intended receiver, Ashton Lampkin, Ramon Richards were juggling the ball.
A lot of time for Rush there. They may get
personal him. Foul, roughing the passer, defense, number 99. 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
That's Trey Carter, a costly penalty.
You see him there, coming late free. Right by Derek Edwards, the tackle, and just cleans up Rush a little late. Overall, the Chips did a great job of picking up that blitz. They came 3 deep on the other side. 2 linebackers and a safety, and there was an open man in Cooper. The catch should have been made, but a lucky break for CMU with the roughing the passer call.
So now new life, first down to 31. Rush, he's got some room to run. Cooper Rush dives forward up to the 12-yard line, able to scramble for 19 yards. Jordan Stearns there gets credit for the tackle.
Now watch the decisiveness here by the quarterback. We saw before in the first half where he had his eyes downfield looking to throw. This time he knew there was no one to get it to. He made the decision to run. He tucked the ball, got a little bit of speed going, and then slowed down and started confusing people. It's hard for these defenders. They don't know if the quarterback's going to slide. That's a big guy. What do you do when he's coming at you?
Jaire Hayes in the backfield. He had three touchdowns last week. They hand off to him. He cuts it back and takes it up to the 8, gets 4. Second down and 6 coming up.
Jaire Hayes getting more experience in this program, and that was more like the type of run we should have seen from Jonathan Ward a little bit earlier in the drive. He stretched it a little bit, but when it was time to, he got both arms on the ball and got behind his feet. Transfer from the City College of San Francisco. Bonamigo, did he have to go all the way out to the West Coast to get that guy?
Second and 6. It's Hayes again. Again trying to cut it back. Second effort, pushing forward up to the 5-yard line. Able to get 3. First contact, Chad Whitener.
And these are the type of tough runs that you're going to have to see from Central Michigan against this Cowboys defense if they want to have a chance to win this game. A good job pushing the pile and making it for a pretty manageable third down situation. Remember, they can get a first down here without scoring a touchdown, so that could affect the play call.
Third and 3, they have to get to the 2 for the first down. And now a timeout is going to be used here by Central Michigan.
Central Michigan has called their first timeout.
Third and 3 from the 5 coming up when we come back for CMU.
Today,
you have no idea how high this goes.
The truth will be revealed. George Clooney, Julia Roberts, and director Jodie Foster bring you an edge-of-your-seat thriller that doesn't let up for a minute. Don't miss Money Monster, now on Blu-ray.
You say insane, I say I train. You say freakish, I say frequent. Insane, I train. Freakish, frequent. Let's run the whole thing back. You say ridiculous, I say meticulous. You say incredible, I say inevitable. Ridiculous, meticulous. Incredible, inevitable. Let's run the whole thing back. Carbs to compete, electrolytes to replenish.
Experience the thrill of the Lexus IS F-Sport, because the ultimate expression of power is control. This is the pursuit of perfection.
The Cowboys have no defense. They're nothing. They've been nothing for the last 4 years.
Chandler.
We turn to vets for animal care.
This dog is a baby.
But where do vets turn when average care won't cut it? Welcome to Animal ER. The patients and issues are exceptional. Luckily, so is the staff.
There's almost nothing we can't do at Gulf Coast now.
You're not just treating a pet, you're treating the whole family.
It just makes it all worthwhile.
Animal ER, a new series starts tonight at 10 on Nat Geo Wild.
You're a cop in everything but name.
Saving Gotham's not my job anymore.
I do this, there's no turning back.
No, there isn't.
GCPD is not Gotham. Gotham listens to me.
I want an army like me.
I don't think Gotham's running out of monsters anytime soon.
Gotham, season premiere, Monday, September 19th on Fox.
FS1 College Football is presented by Geico. Here in Stillwater, the home of the Cowboys. It's 17-10, number 22, Oklahoma State leading Central Michigan. But John Bonamigo's team is on the doorstep. It is 3rd and 3 from the 5. 13th play of the drive coming up. Out of the timeout. Bocci, the fullback in. Jaire Hayes, the running back. Lofting one to the end zone. Jump ball tipped. Did he catch it? Touchdown! Tyler Conklin again. 2nd touchdown of the game for the former basketball player.
Yeah, from Chesterfield, Michigan. This was a straight fade the whole way. And he's doing some hand fighting with Richards, but goes up and secures it with one hand. I love how he waited and looked at the ref the whole time waiting for the signal, because I don't know if he knew that he secured it the whole time. Tipped it to himself twice, and I think that's good. What a catch.
They could have tried for a first down instead of the timeout. No, we're going for the touchdown. And now Brian Eby on to tie this game at 17. With 5:16 to go here in the third quarter, Central Michigan out of the MAC is all tied up with number 22 Oklahoma State out of the Big 12. Tyler Conklin from Cooper Rush. 2nd touchdown of the day.
There are countless not very smart things we do with our car. But with TireRack.com, at least you know you got your tires right. Right now, you could get up to a $70 Visa prepaid card when you buy a set of 4 select general tires. For details, go to TireRack.com.
Want to go for a bike ride?
TireRack.com. Find, deliver, install. Smarter.
Domino's it is.
No, I want salad.
Oh, no.
So we're getting salad, right?
Luckily at Domino's, we love pizza so much we've added salads, so no one can veto pizza night. Try one with a medium two-topping pizza for $5.99 each.
Is this my car?
State Farm knows that for every one of those moments, there's one of these.
Is this my car?
This is ridiculous!
This is ridiculous! Ah!
From car insurance to car loans, State Farm is here to help life go right.
Sometimes a project becomes more than just checking off your to-do list.
Now on sale at your locally owned True Value. Granite Gold Daily Cleaner for only $4.99. A Quickie Professional Corn Broom. And Master Mechanic Motor Oil. Behind every project is a True Value.
Experience the thrill of the Lexus Performance Line. Because the ultimate expression of power is control. This is the pursuit of perfection.
Another long scoring drive from Central Michigan. This time 13 plays, 89 yards, almost 6:45, and it's Tyler Conklin for the 2nd time today in the end zone.
And you can see just a little bit of hand fighting with Richards. Richards ends up a little bit out of position, but not bad coverage. It's just Conklin's size, 5 inches taller than Richards, really reaches out there with that right hand and finds a way to secure it. This guy's a great tight end, really good for CMU. Conklin and Kroll, both of them, have been very patient, and the game has really come to them as Cooper Rush has found his rhythm throwing the ball.
17-17, 5:16 to go here in the third quarter. Brian Eby to kick off. Jeff Carr is back deep. This is in the end zone and a touchback. And time for a game break. Let's go back to L.A. and check in with Mike Hill.
All right, guys, check this one out. 9th-ranked Georgia trail, Nichols State, 14-13 midway through third, but it's come alive. Aaron Davis rocks Chase 4K. Ball's loose. Lorenzo Carter scoops and scores, 22-yard TD. Georgia with 2 TDs in less than a minute. They lead it 26-14 in the third. Justin Petros, back to you.
All right, so Georgia's doing okay there now, but Oklahoma State, ranked number 22. They've got their hands full here, starting at the 25. Justice Hill in the backfield to open up this drive. Rudolph hands off. And this will be a 5-yard run for Justice Hill on first down. Malik Fountain, Nathan Ricketts combined for the tackle. Well, look at these two quarterbacks. 193 yards for Cooper Rush, couple of touchdowns, both QBs with two touchdowns.
Really, the time of possession has been unbelievable. Coming into this drive, CMU with 24:55 and Oklahoma State with only 11:50 about it. And that is lopsided even for an Oklahoma State team that plays quick offense.
Second and five again. The handoff, a big hole, Justice Hill. And that gets this crowd to its feet. A 17-yard run for Hill. Alex Briones and Amari Coleman finally bring him down. And here, empty backfield. They go hurry up. The quick pass to McCleskey. And McCleskey gets forced out of bounds. Winslow Chapman able to push him out, picks up eight.
And that is the Cowboys' tempo there. You see the big explosive play from the back. The crowd gets excited right up to the line of scrimmage, and they get it to the slot guy out in the flat. They did that to score their first touchdown of the game to McCleskey. The tempo is really a killer in this stadium with this offense. They're good at it.
Second down and two. Play action. Rudolph with time. Wide open is McCleskey. McCleskey nearly gets stripped. Malik Fountain was coming down with that arm trying to rake it free, but it's a 28-yard pickup, and here comes Oklahoma State with tempo. First and 10 inside the 20. Rudolph to the end zone for Washington, incomplete. Amari Coleman there on the coverage.
Yeah, good job. He looked a little bit like Jordan Stearns all day. He looks like he has a little bit of hold of the back between the two and the eight Washington's jersey, but not too bad, and is able to punch it away. I was really impressed with the play before. McCleskey coming across that zone right by the middle linebacker, and Rudolph having the patience to get him the ball.
Chris Carson back in at tailback now on second down and 10. Carson spinning and spins right into a bunch of players. Black jerseys, white jerseys. It's Joe Ostman. A loss of two on the play. Ostman from St. Ignace, Michigan. He's a Uper just across the Mackinac Bridge.
Mason Rudolph there checking to a run play. Thought he had something there on the weak side, and it just wasn't.
Now third and 12. Rudolph lofting one, jump ball, it's incomplete for McCleskey. Again, it's Amari Coleman there on the coverage. And so here comes the field goal unit on for Oklahoma State.
And this is good technique from that boundary corner. Look at how he tries to push McCleskey down to the sideline, but the ball was right on both of them. McCleskey wasn't quite ready for it, and Coleman was in good position. Different kicker.
Going to be a 35-yard attempt here for Ben Grogan. And Grogan able to connect from 35 yards out and give Oklahoma State the lead once again. But it's just by three with under three to go in the third.
I enlisted in the Army in 2005. I went to Iraq three times and Afghanistan once. She's the culprit that ripped our door off. 2,000-pound animal bumping into a steel door creates quite a bit of damage. Actually use the app, take pictures of it right there for USAA, and they take care of the rest. USAA is great about working with both active and separated military. I'm Josh Eilers, and I'm a USAA member for life.
Call USAA today to talk about your insurance needs.
To create Starbucks Double Shot Espresso, we put our energy into giving it the bold, rich taste of real Starbucks espresso with a hint of cream. So you can put your energy where it really counts. Starbucks Double Shot Espresso, real life energy.
Some things are simply impossible to ignore. The strikingly designed Lexus NX Turbo and Hybrid. The SUV that dares to go beyond utility. This is the pursuit of perfection.
All new Wednesday. They call him the Angel of Death.
When I knock people out, I put them to sleep.
Those eyes look through your soul.
Will he crush another fighter's dream?
What did I get myself into?
He's hurt!
An all-new Ultimate Fighter. Wednesday at 10 on FS1.
Mondays.
It's every man for himself out here.
This is the Outer Banks.
Okay.
She will make you work for your payday.
We don't want you. We need you, baby.
And she will show you no mercy.
Fishing here on the Outer Banks is not for the faint of heart.
Wicked Tuna Outer Banks. New episodes Mondays at 9 on the National Geographic Channel.
You've never mentioned your mother before.
She's going to kill me.
So, Mama, Morningstar is on the loose.
How far can a celestial being get?
Well, she's stupid hot, and she's got a credit card.
Oh, sure. I mean, what could possibly go wrong? She's coming for me. I know it.
Lucifer. Are you praying?
Yes. Usually works. This thing on.
Lucifer returns Monday, September 19th on Fox.
Bears singing along to Garth Brooks here in Stillwater. It's 20-17. Oklahoma State now leading Central Michigan. And tonight, it's the UFC prelims 203, 7 p.m. Eastern on FS1. You can watch it live on Fox Sports Go. It's Jessica I against Betch Koheya. That's tonight, 7 p.m. Eastern on FS1. Your sunglasses are upside down. Maybe those are the rally sunglasses.
Well, they need it a little bit. They want to score touchdowns, not field goals. And the Chippewas did a good job of taking that punch, dealing with the tempo, especially with McCleskey getting loose on the perimeter and forcing a field goal.
Matt Amendola, who drilled that 53-yard field goal, kicks off here. Jonathan Ward will take a knee for a touchback. And Central Michigan will start at the 25. The last four possessions for Central Michigan.
Long drives.
Mm-hmm. 11 plays, 79 yards. 10 plays, 53 yards. 12 plays, 89 yards.
The longer they hold the ball,
89 yards.
Yeah, the longer they hold the ball, it's a much more difficult situation for the Cowboys. Now, again, they're used to playing a lot of downs defensively, but when you have a team with a fullback that's kind of slowly grinding you down, kind of punching you in the gut, body blows, it can really wear on you in the fourth quarter. And some of those two-yard runs become 6 or 7 yard runs. We'll see how they establish it here as the second half unfolds.
Devin Spaulding in, play clock down to 2. Play action, Rush, pressured, and Rush goes down. Sacked by Jarrell Owens. Had a sack last week, now has one this week, a loss of 9.
Owens is the very experienced guy coming off the edge, played in every game in 2015, come up big in late game situations, kind of replacing Emmanuel Ogba, of course, not that he's very replaceable, but they need a guy to make big plays in those situations. And I'm not sure I really like the play call, trying for a play action situation there when you haven't really established enough of the run. I think Central Michigan's better when they're playing in front of the chains as opposed to behind them.
Rush, the quick pass to Willis, and Willis gets chased down from behind by Kirk Tucker. A 4-yard pickup. Third and long coming up. Third and 15 here for the Chippewas.
And the last third and long the Chippewas had was really elongated the drive because of a roughing the passer call. See if OSU could be disciplined here.
Setting up a little screen. It's Willis again. Edison Magruder and Trey Flowers sniffed it out. Gave up just 8 yards. gives a little bit more room for Cooper Mojienko for him to punt. Coming up on a minute to go here in this third quarter. Jalen McCleskey is back at his own 28-yard line. McCleskey with room to return. With the speed, broke through a couple of tackles. And he is down at the 44-yard line. A 45-yard punt, 18-yard return. And a player is down now. That's Mitch Stanisek for Central Michigan. The junior out of Grand Rapids. An academic All-MAC last year.
Looks like they're checking his knee, and it was, he got whipped by his own guy. That can happen out there. Pretty good tackling by Central Michigan. Remember, Oklahoma State is known as a very good, very solid special teams touchdown scoring team and a very good defensive touchdown scoring team. And the Chips have done a good job today making sure that they've limited those big plays as Stanisek has helped off.
Stanisek got hit by his own player, number 22, Gary Jones. Not putting any pressure on that leg. Hate to see that. 35 seconds to go here in this third quarter. Rudolph. His team leading by three. Rudolph stepping up, makes a move, slides forward across midfield. He's down at the 49 of Central Michigan. Gets 7 yards on first down, second and three.
I like the play by Rudolph there. He called the backs to run a route over the middle, and they kind of cleared that area out with the linebackers, and when he saw an opening, he just tucked it and went.
Does he run one more play, or is that the end of this third quarter? 7 seconds to go.
Who are we talking about? Oklahoma State, of course they're going to run a play.
Just getting it off. A little shuttle pass for McCleskey. McCleskey bounces off a defender, gets the first down, and that will end this third quarter. We've got a good one. 20-17. Oklahoma State leading Central Michigan. FS1 College Football presented by Geico. Return after these messages.
College football kicks off with two intense in-state matchups. First on FS1, SMU faces Baylor. Then on Fox, BYU takes on bitter rival Utah. Don't miss all the action. Today beginning at 3:30 Eastern on FS1, then at 7 Eastern on Fox.
You say crazy, I say crafted. You say savage, I say practiced. Crazy, crafted, savage, practiced. Let's run that whole thing back. You say unbelievable, I say achievable. You say incredible, I say inevitable. Unbelievable, achievable, incredible, inevitable. Let's run that whole thing back. Carbs to compete, electrolytes to replenish.
This piece is so you. I saw it and I was just like, oh, I have to have it.
State Farm knows that for every one of those moments, there's one of these.
This piece is so you.
I saw it and I was like, have to have it.
From renter's insurance to rewards credit cards, State Farm is here to help life go right.
Every cookie here at Left Twix is extra crisp, so it stays crunchy when we apply caramel and chocolate.
Right Twix has the same thing.
They have packing tape like that over at Right Twix?
Try both. Pick a side. Twix.
At Lexus, what we learn on the track doesn't stay on the track. It just finds more street legal form. Experience the power and precision of the Lexus F-Sport Performance Line. This is the pursuit of perfection.
This game has been close, and the stats are close. Start of the fourth quarter. Rudolph, pump fake. And that pass is incomplete. Washington could not hold on to it. Nathan Ricketts poked it away from him. Brickwood Central Michigan has done time of possession, doubling up Oklahoma State.
Yeah, that's a big, huge deal. Even though Oklahoma State is relatively comfortable with that kind of time of possession, not with an offense like this. But they've done a good job of kind of solidifying themselves here in the second half and moving the ball more freely.
Pass, high and incomplete, looking for McCleskey. Speaking of big and huge, that circle that you drew, I mean, that was like the entire graphic.
No, it was right there over the time of possession. There's a lot of time there. You know, I had to get it all in there. I have giant fingers. Most of them are broken. That's another errant pass by Rudolph, and he had McCleskey in that little window of the zone. They've done a good job of finding some windows over the middle in that zone throughout the afternoon, but another miss by Rudolph.
Third and 10 now, 1 for 8 on third downs. Today is Oklahoma State. Rudolph has got time, dumps it off for Barry J. Sanders, and he gets bottled up just 1 yard. And I tell you what, it was a late arriving crowd here at Boone Pickens Stadium. After the half, a lot of fans left, and the fans that have stayed, they're not happy with what they're seeing. They're in a ball game against the Chippewas of Central Michigan. Zach Siner's on to punt. Emmett Thomas is back inside his own 10. Trying to down it, and they will. They will down it at the 5. A 37-yard punt. Siner is doing his job.
Timeout on the field for media.
Just underway here in the fourth quarter. 14 minutes to go. A 3-point game. Oklahoma State in a fight with Central Michigan.
Advanced Audi A4.
Americans don't celebrate the good enough canyon. We didn't aim to be second to the moon. Verizon doesn't settle for good enough either. So now we are introducing Verizon LTE Advanced. With 50% faster peak speeds in more than 450 cities coast to coast. So don't settle for an unlimited plan with limits. Switch now and get our best deal. 20 gigs of limitless data with 4 lines for only $160. Welcome to the Next Gen Network.
We got married in June.
On Tuna Day.
There's a Subway 350 sub of the day to help you remember life's important days. Every day a different 6-inch sub for just $3.50 every day of the week at Subway.
Her name is Terry.
She was born on Sweet Onion Chicken Teriyaki Day.
Is that iced tea?
Nope, it's lemonade.
Is that iced tea?
Lemonade.
Iced tea?
What's with these people, man? Lemonade. Read the sign. Lemonade. Read it.
Okay.
Delicious.
Iced tea at a lemonade stand? Surprising. What's not surprising? How much money Marin saved by switching to Geico.
It's lemonade, man.
15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Introducing new Mist Twist, the only lemon lime soda with a twist of real juice. It's a crisp, refreshing twist on lemon lime. Insist on the twist.
FS1 College Football is presented by Geico, back on the campus of Oklahoma State University. The number 22 ranked Cowboys lead Central Michigan by 3. The Chippewas facing Mike Gundy's team, and they'll have to go a long way right now, starting at their own 5.
Let's see if they can grind it out, or if the athleticism of the Cowboys is going to take over here in the fourth quarter.
Jare Hayes in the backfield to open up this drive, and he gets stopped at the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Last year's game, 24-13, Oklahoma State won. Central Michigan led 13-10 in the third quarter.
This one doesn't feel too much different, does it?
No. Another handoff up the middle. Hayes able to get some breathing room. Up to the 12, gets 7. Jordan Stearns trips him up.
Just like you said, that breathing room was great, and Hayes did a good job getting underneath the guard who was pulling around. Watch number 70 pull around here, and then Hayes will get right underneath him, and that's a great job. That's how you run power. You got to get right off that guard's behind and find a hole. He could even got closer to that guard and had a better chance of breaking that tackle.
Now a 3rd and 3. 4 for 10 on third downs. Rush to throw, and he completes the pass to Conklin. And Conklin has the first down. So Tyler Conklin is having himself a day.
Conklin there in the slot. You see him, number 83. He runs what they call an out route. Didn't really sell the inside much at all because he had to get out and show his numbers to the quarterback. And that's what I would call a possession type of catch. He really made sure he had it, and he was right at the sticks. Well done.
Gets the first down. Play clock down to 3. Down to 1. Rush just gets it off. Over the middle. Flags are thrown. Conklin comes down with it for 15 yards. Josiah Kim there on the tackle.
Conklin and Rush are putting on a bit of a show against a Big 12 defense here. Let's see what the call is. It came from the secondary.
Holding, defense number 9. The penalties declined. The play results in a first down.
The hold is there, and you can see it, but no matter to Conklin, he's strong, and he's able to go up and make that catch. Cooper Rush takes another pretty good shot from 2 D linemen from the Cowboys. But he stands in now.
Jonathan Ward, the true freshman, now in at tailback. The handoff to him. And Ward got hit right away by Vincent Taylor, the big junior out of San Antonio. No gain, 2nd and 10.
Kimball wants to get any kind of push in this front seven of Oklahoma State simply because of their size.
Handoff. Spalding. And he's going to lose some. Mote Maile. Third and 13 coming up here for Central Michigan.
Another big third down. Just having such a hard time establishing their run. They've had a great time of possession number throughout the game. They've done what they wanted to do, I think, offensively. And you see those third down conversions. Oklahoma State, 1 out of 9. Central Michigan's had more success.
Central Michigan has called their
with the play clock winding down. CMU forced to call a timeout. Third and long coming up.
Okay, so we'll cover this at rehearsal.
See you there, Joy.
Skip Bayless. You ready to make television history?
Hey, partner, pretty great, huh?
It's awesome.
Shannon, I'm so glad to have you on board.
This is how I used to feel moments before the kickoff.
Yeah, I can't wait to get going.
Fox is where we belong, Skip. Here, we can let it rip.
No filter, no agenda. It's time to unleash.
Undisputed with Skip and Shannon. Weekdays only on FS1.
At Pizza Hut, our original pan dough rises fresh every day, making it crispy on the outside, soft and chewy on the inside. And now you can get our original pan as part of the $6.99 any deal. That's two medium pizzas with any toppings, any crust, any specialty for just $6.99 each. Only at Pizza Hut.
Some ask, why would you do this? She asks, why wouldn't you? Coors Light. Whatever your mouth, climb on.
Got a runner.
Hey, follow me!
Better TV starts now.
PlayStation.
To go here in the fourth quarter. Oklahoma State leading by 3. Time now for our Nissan Heisman Watch here in week 2.
You love it. You love my Heisman Watch. Christian McCaffrey. If he didn't win the Heisman last year, how's he going to win it this year? But you got to put him in there. He's unreal. I know Greg Ward's shoulders hurt today. He's not going to play against Lamar. But after watching him against Oklahoma, my goodness, Nick Chubb is still great. And what can you say about JT Barrett? He leads a great team.
On 3rd and 13, going deep over the middle, complete. Mark Chapman has it all the way down to the 31 of Oklahoma State. On 3rd and 13, they get 41.
Chapman loops with the outside receiver and ends up on the inside and makes a great play. He appeared in all 13 games last year. He's got great chemistry with Cooper Rush, and pardon me for saying they weren't really a downfield threat against Oklahoma State. That's about as downfield as you can get in a huge conversion.
All of a sudden, Central Michigan in great shape. Out of the timeout, Cooper Rush lofting one to his running back Spalding for the touchdown. 31 yards. And Central Michigan has taken its first lead of the game.
Now, it is hard for a tailback to adjust to a deep ball and find it out of the sky like that. What a job by Devin Spalding. You're going to see him take an outside route. Nobody really gets any kind of piece of him. He goes right by the Mike linebacker, Chad Whitener, before the play, and a perfect throw by Cooper Rush. And how about that? Boone Pickens Stadium shot two deep balls in a row from Cooper Rush, and the Chiefs have the lead.
Brian Evie's extra point is good. 72 yards on the last two passes. Cooper Rush, first to Mark Chapman, then to Devin Spaulding, his running back. Oh, wow. 9:40 to go. Central Michigan up by four.
Go further. Go faster. Go one better. The Jaguar F-Type. For great offers, visit your local Jaguar retailer today.
What's it like to be in good hands? Like the power to earn Allstate reward points every time I drive.
You want my number?
And cash back for driving safe. N means getting more from your car insurance with DriveWise.
It's good to be in good hands.
Starbucks Double Shot Energy. It's the bold taste of real Starbucks coffee blended with a variety of delicious flavors. For the energy you need all day and the great taste you want right now, Starbucks Double Shot, real life energy.
After 162 games, the only thing that matters now is October.
You're a cop in everything but name.
Saving Gotham's not my job anymore.
I do this, there's no turning back.
No, there isn't.
GCPD is not Gotham. Gotham listens to me.
I want an army like me.
I don't think Gotham's running out of monsters anytime soon.
Gotham, season premiere, Monday, September 19th on Fox.
Tuesday, producing music brought Suge Knight fame.
Suge's greatest skill was his ability to see what talent can become.
And those who supported him talk about the good life.
Had access to this Rolls Royce limousine.
It was incredible.
But those who defied him,
he's somebody you didn't want to mess with,
have another story to tell.
They had guns, we had guns, our secretaries had guns.
The showdowns continue with Facing Suge Knight, part of a limited series Tuesday at 9 on National Geographic.
The offensive coordinator, Morris Watts, told us on the phone that Devin Spaulding could line up as a wide receiver and be one of their best wide receivers. He was doing it before he got hurt last year. Great option out of the backfield. Well, he just caught a 31-yard touchdown pass from Cooper Rush to give Central Michigan a four-point lead over Oklahoma State. How about Cooper Rush? 4 for 4 in that drive, 91 yards. They went 95 yards. Every drive seems to be long. Evie to kick off. And I think this one may have been blown off the tee as he was coming to kick.
The ball fell off the tee just prior to it being kicked.
You're right.
The play will be replayed.
Imagine that moment of panic. Right there. When you're the kicker and you realize you're going to have to kick the ball the wrong way. You're praying that that official blows the whistle, and he did, luckily for Evie.
Chris Lacy and Jeff Carr back deep for Oklahoma State.
Well, you know what Boone Pickens says. This is the Saudi Arabia of wind. You know, there's a lot of wind here in Oklahoma. You can take advantage of that.
Carr will take a knee in the end zone. A couple of big throws by Cooper Rush on that last drive.
First, the beautiful one and the holding call to Conklin. They didn't need the call. There's Chapman way down the field on the third and long. And then the very next play, beautiful throw on the wheel route by Devin Spaulding, who hauled it in like a wide receiver, just like his offensive coordinator Morris Watts told us. Devin Spaulding, I've been pretty impressed with. He's standing there with Cooper Rush, and you see his numbers. Cooper Rush, so poised, came out in this game not looking himself, took a couple hits, a couple of errant passes, but things have changed dramatically for him, and let's see what Mason Rudolph can muster up with this team at home in trouble in the fourth quarter.
In trouble indeed, down by four on first down. Rudolph throwing, and he completes the pass to Jawan Seals for 17 yards. That's a good start to the drive here for the Cowboys. They go back to Seals. And Seals gets wrapped up by Josh Cox. The Cowboys sideline is looking for a flag. They don't get it. An 11-yard completion. So back-to-back first downs to Jawan Seals, who has been quiet in this game.
Out of the field for a Central Michigan injury.
Injured player.
That's Tony Anise, the best safety, really the defensive leader for the Chippewas, and he started limping around after the original throw to Seals, and they got the playoff before he could get down or get off the field. You see, when they're stretching him out, it usually is a cramp, and you hope for that.
It's a guy on the Jim Thorpe Award watch list.
Oh, he's a stud, a high school quarterback, and there's a lot of those guys out here for this Central Michigan team, a lot of guys that played high school quarterback, which means they have a great understanding of the game, but they're also tough.
Two passes on the drive for Mason Rudolph, both to Jawan Seals. They've gone for 28 yards. Rudolph gets rid of it to Carson. And Carson able to dive forward up to the 35. A 12-yard completion. And Rudolph barking out instructions. Oklahoma State going quickly again. Quick pass, McCleskey. And this is Oklahoma State football right now. Briones and Cox combined for the tackle, a 9-yard completion to McCleskey. That's the 10th catch. That's the 11th catch of the day for McCleskey.
Oh, he's had a good day.
A career day.
They like to throw it to him immediately after they get a first down out there in the flat. You can see the Popes can take momentum back in a hurry.
Justice Hill on the carry, and that's a good open field tackle by Sean Bunting.
Just a freshman. Bunting doing a good job of breaking down and making the tackle. Getting right to the knees of Hill before he could make another move and get upfield.
Second and 9 from the 24. Rudolph, 4 for 4 on the drive. Pressured, and Rudolph goes down. Sacked. Nate Brisson Fast, a loss of 6.
Brisson Fast is only 260 pounds, but he's rangy. There he makes an inside move and just kind of muscles by the guard and gets his arms on Mason Rudolph. Marcus Keys, the left guard, beat on that play. He's one of the only new starters on this Oklahoma State front.
Now a 3rd and 15. Oklahoma State 1 for 9 on third downs today. Rudolph, pressure coming. Lost one to the sideline, and it's incomplete. The flag is thrown. Another flag is thrown. Chris Lacy, the intended receiver, bunting on the coverage. I'd love to see a replay of this.
I think we can accommodate you.
Pass interference, defense, number 27. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
This is the freshman out there, Justin, and it looked like he was being grabbed.
Right.
Kind of double grabbing. To me, that would be a no call. Lacy with his arms all over him. You saw one flag come and then the other one, and they both decided it would be on the freshman, Bunting. I don't know if I like that call. I thought that was pretty good coverage. He got grabbed first.
That's why I wanted to see it.
Exactly right.
That's the second pass interference on a 3rd and long against Central Michigan. Happened on the opening drive with James Washington. That's 5 penalties for 60 yards against CMU. Now Jeff Carr in the backfield. On first down, the whistle is blown before the snap.
Prior to the snap, false start, offense, number 28, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Well, they got James Washington, and that's who they were trying to get the ball to. So James Washington just a little antsy there,
game
knowing they were trying to get him the ball.
Please reset the game clock to 7 minutes, 22 seconds.
Here he is.
7:22.
Just a Thank second you. Early with that stutter step, and that's what drew the flag.
To Lacy. Otis Kearney on the tackle, a pickup of 7. So it should be second down and 8. And the way that Central Michigan moves the ball, you wonder, you may have to score a touchdown if you're Oklahoma State.
The
field goal may not be good enough.
They definitely go a lot slower. I mean, these two teams could not be more different. And it's very interesting seeing them come up against each other here in the fourth quarter in a tight game.
Rudolph swings it out for Carson. Where do they mark him? It looks like he has the first down. A 9-yard completion. Joe Ostman able to finally get him out.
And that is a harder throw than it looks. 1 foot in front of the numbers for Carson. A very nice delivery for Rudolph, but a good job by Carson staying in bounds and getting the first down.
The ruling on the field on the previous play was complete pass out of bounds. That ruling is under further review.
Well, let's see if he stepped out of bounds before the first down marker.
This will be a spot issue because I think the completion was made.
Right.
We'll see if he gets out of bounds before the marker. There you see, obviously, a completion. I think he towed it. I think he did a pretty good job of towing it, unless one of those early feet that came down was out. I think that's a pretty good call.
It would be the right foot.
Yeah, where was the ball?
Let's bring in Mike Pereira.
5.
Mike, you're looking at this as we're looking at this. And
yeah, I mean, we're looking down the sidelines, and he really doesn't step out of bounds until he gets to the 5-yard line. His left foot is the one that comes closest, about a 7, but the shot that we showed shows that there is a little bit of green between that white and the field. So I think until that right foot steps out of bounds, he's good. He's okay there with that foot, and I think really you're looking at him being out of bounds right there at the 5. I think it has to stay as a first down.
The replay official is Richard Jordan. If it stands, it will be a first down. It'll be first and goal from the 5 for Oklahoma State. Now, we did speak with Richard Jordan during halftime to ask about the first touchdown of the game scored by Jalen McCleskey, which ironically enough was also on this same sideline. And we thought maybe he had stepped out of bounds. It was close. Why didn't it go to review? And we spoke to Richard Jordan. He said, I looked at it up here, and based on all the camera angles, I looked at it. I didn't stop the game because no matter how I looked at it, I didn't have enough evidence to overturn it. So I could have stopped the game and looked and looked and looked, and it would have stood.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands. The pass was complete, and the runner was out of bounds at the 5-yard line. First down.
And by the way, once again, Mike Pereira is correct.
100%. I wonder if he'll be 100% all day. I would bet on it.
It's a pretty good bet.
And he's going to look good on camera, too.
10th play of the drive is coming up. Mason Rudolph is perfect on this drive, although I don't know if you like all those sixes. Carson in the backfield. First and goal from the five. Down by four are the Cowboys. That one is picked off in the end zone. Josh Cox, the first turnover of the game.
What a read by Josh Cox. And his defensive coordinator, Greg Colby, told us he's very smart. He's a very heady player out of Warren, Michigan. Watch him recognize this and get under the ball where Washington has no chance at it. The throw was errant, there's no doubt about it, and we've seen a lot of those from Mason Rudolph today, but a great job by Cox seeing it and getting under it, and Rudolph's reaction, man, would he love to have that back.
He was a perfect 6-for-6 on the drive prior to that. What a turn of events here. Now 6:33 to go. Central Michigan has one timeout remaining. Look at this. Now the defense has to step up for Oklahoma State. On first down, the handoff to Spalding. It's Spalding. Has it taken away. There's the defense stepping up for Oklahoma State.
And that was him, Devonte Averett, the guy that stripped the ball last week and flipped it over to Ramon Richards for that great touchdown. He does it again and rips that ball away.
The ruling on the field is fumble recovered by the defense.
There's Spalding, and look at number 40 get in there and rip. You see him, he did it again. He did it last week, dislodges that ball, and what a great play. And that's part of the opportunistic nature of this Cowboys defense. They teach that stuff and try to get as many turnovers as you can. And man, did they need that. Glenn Spencer's got to be happy.
The fumble recovery in return of 10 yards. It is Devonte Averett out of Detroit, Michigan, playing against Central Michigan.
Now he's up. That's
he's
the guy.
He's up, and he gets the ovation.
He was a boxer in high school, Justin, and I think that helps with his hands.
I agree.
You get those quick hands to get in and dislodge the ball, and it's not easy to get the ball away from Spalding. He is an experienced back. Great play.
Wow, the answer by Glenn Spencer's defense, giving the ball back to the offense. Now, can Central Michigan's defense answer and just hold Oklahoma State to three? Mason Rudolph with second life. Carson in the backfield. It's Carson on the handoff, up the middle. And he gets the seven. Malik Fountain, Nathan Ricketts combined for the stop, a 5-yard pickup.
Rudolph's got a lot of poise, but he really has missed some throws this afternoon. And I think it's smart to get Carson the ball there and just try to get a little closer, get a little more comfortable.
Rudolph looks to the sidelines. Change the play. Play clock winding down. Rudolph locked in one in the corner of the end zone again. Incomplete, looking for James Washington. Amari Coleman there on the coverage. Third and five coming up.
Well, they're trying to get the ball to Washington every way they can. Trying to get into the hands of their playmakers and just another fade. Good job by Coleman, and well, it's just a little far for Washington to get to. They don't seem to be on the same page as far as where they want to place those fades.
1-for-9 on third downs today. Rudolph, design run, Rudolph! He's got himself the first down. He's down shy of the end zone.
And I like that he went and got it himself. He's been struggling a little bit. Now they're going to go fast.
We're going to make timeout on the field for measurement.
Or maybe it's real close to that first down marker.
Here's the play. It was a called draw. You see it because Carson went to lead block on the backside. Rudolph is a big guy, 6'5", 235, can lean that big body down.
Tell you, from the initial run, it looked like he had it. From this, the spot, wow.
Now the fans don't like it here in Stillwater. Now this is a situation on a fourth and really short that you would usually wonder if the quarterback could get under center and run a quarterback sneak, but they don't do a lot of that. Here's the spot again. Where was the knee down? It's hard to tell in that cluster of tacklers.
Look at that initial spot where the... Well, it's fourth and one. Carson's in. Whistle before the snap. Timeout taken by Oklahoma State.
Oklahoma State has taken their first timeout of the half. This will be a 30-second team timeout. Timeout on the field for media.
Fourth and one coming up.
Shannon, you may be a Hall of Famer, but Gronk may end up being the best ever. He has over 5,500 yards and 65 spikes, and he's just getting started.
How many?
A Bud Light party is going to address the issues that matter.
We are going to bring America together. Hard.
It's a party for everyone. Men.
Yeah. Women.
People of all genders.
But, you know, gender identity, it's really a spectrum, and we don't need these labels.
Beer should have labels, not people.
Kablam! Yeah.
We don't care. We'll sell you beer.
We'll sell you a beer any day of the week.
Yeah. Hey, you got this party hopping. Plasma blender. What you powering all this with?
Honda. EU 2000. Lightweight, reliable, super quiet. Can't beat them. What about you?
Grandpa. He's been going strong for 82 years. I gotta go.
Nothing powers your party like a Honda. Honda generators. Very smart.
In the Big 12 Conference and nationally, over $2.7 billion in athletic scholarships are awarded annually to college athletes. College athletes receive the full cost of attendance and graduate at a higher rate than other students in general. 8 in 10 will earn a bachelor's degree. 1 in 6 student athletes are first-generation scholars. 2/3 of former athletes say they were better prepared for careers because of college athletics. The Big 12 Conference, turning winners into leaders.
College football kicks off with two intense in-state matchups. First on FS1, SMU faces Baylor. Then on Fox, BYU takes on bitter rival Utah. Don't miss all the action. Today beginning at 3:30 Eastern on FS1, then at 7 Eastern on Fox.
College football on FS1 is presented by Geico. 24-20. Yes, you're seeing that correctly. Central Michigan leading Oklahoma State. Mike Gundy's team is facing 4th and 1. From the 2. It's a wildcat formation and the direct toss. Touchdown. James Washington. Flag on the play. Dylan Stoner is lined up at quarterback. Direct snap to James Washington.
There's There's no foul on play for holding. The resulting play is a touchdown.
Well, there you go. We told you that Mason Rudolph didn't have to come off the field anymore from the quarterback position in the red zone. But he did. They replaced him with a true freshman, Dylan Stoner, who didn't even take the snap. It went straight to Washington coming across.
Oh, it was
a
pass.
He got it and pushed it forward. Yeah, that happened quickly. So touchdown pass for Dylan Stoner. Congratulations, young man. True freshman. Slot receiver with the touchdown pass.
Now Grogan on for the extra point. Oklahoma State is back on top by three with 5:12 to go. Points off turnovers.
Now that was a very timed up play. A great job by Brad Lundblad, the center, to really tie up the snap. And look at Washington. He's really got to throttle down and really keep an eye on Stoner until he's able to secure the ball. Montemago not happy. And that's how he felt when the flag was picked up. He saw a hold. And if there was a flag, you'd have to assume somebody else saw a hold too. They picked it up.
So all of a sudden, Mason Rudolph, who thought he may have cost his team the game by throwing that interception in the end zone, his defense gotten the ball back. Thanks to that strip fumble by Devontae Averett. And now, after the timeout, and a great call by Mike Gundy and the offensive coordinator Mike Yurcich, they put in the freshman Dylan Stoner. A little shovel pass to James Washington. And now, it's a three-point lead for Oklahoma State.
And a great resiliency by Oklahoma State. After the interception, you're down. The crowd is out of it, not to get dejected and to force that turnover.
Mark Chapman's going to return it from a couple yards deep in his own end zone. Chapman trying to cut it back. And he'll get out to the 26. So the last couple of minutes has been kind of crazy.
First, you have the pick. Rudolph throwing it right to Josh Cox, really. Then Spalding gets stripped beautifully by Averett. And the Cowboys ground it out a little bit. Finally, the Wildcat forward pass touchdown to Washington. And Bonamigo doesn't like it. I don't blame him.
Devin Spalding is back in at tailback. About 5 minutes to go. One timeout remaining for Central Michigan. Cooper Rush. He'll pass to his fullback, Joe Bocci. And Bocci makes the catch for 7 yards. Tackle by Avery. Second and three coming up.
Now can the Oklahoma State defense kind of bow up and force the chips into something desperate here? We'll see. They've had a hard time getting off the field on third downs and stopping Cooper Rush from completing passes.
Hand off to Spalding. He gets hit right away. Cole Waltershine, a loss of two. Third and five coming up. Six for 13 on third downs is Central Michigan. Rush swings it out, completes the pass to Spalding. Another third down conversion for the Chippewas.
Spalding doing a good job of kind of getting down and bending his knees and getting that ball. He just runs a swing route and then to the flat. and has to kind of dig down to get that. Finds the first down, and the chips stay alive.
Spalding picks up the pressure. The pass is picked off. Ramon Richards steps in front of Jesse Kroll. Look at Glenn Spencer.
They needed their defense to force turnovers here in the fourth quarter. Coach Bond.